Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will be yassifying your Roblox avatars. This was a highly requested video, so I think I will make this a series. A few days ago, I created posts on YouTube and Discord for you guys to send your Roblox usernames. I'm basically critiquing and improving your outfits. Please remember these are my tips and opinions, and I am not trying to offend anyone. Before we start, make sure to like and subscribe. Okay, now let's go. Let's first start on my YouTube post. I'm gonna randomly choose someone. Let's do this person. I'm gonna yassify their outfit in NB Avatar Studio. Oh my god, their outfit is adorable. Come, let's see. I feel like these sparkles aren't necessary since you can barely see them. Also, the max amount of accessories you can equip is 10, so I want to leave some open slots in case if I add more items. I removed the scissors because it felt out of place. The theme of this avatar is mostly doll and kawaii. If it was kawaii gore doll or hospital, then I would have kept the scissors. Hum, I also think they should add a face. I found this one on my recommended page. I think it really suits the doll vibes. Ooh, the glasses are in the way. Ah, she's so cute. Okay, I don't think the avatar needs glasses since she already has a lot of details around her face. Adding glasses would only make her face area look cluttered. Now I'm finding aura items to make her stand out more. I think pink sparkles would be the best since she has sparkles on her shirt. Perfect. She needs more shapes on her head. Ooh, these items look good. I don't know which one to choose. Let's do the lamb one since I can add a pet lamb. Incorporating animals is great for cute and doll styles. Yes. Alright, I'm picking the lamb headband. And we're done for this outfit. Before. After. Now let's find the next person. Let's do this one. I loaded their avatar the same way as the first one. I don't really like how this idol moves around. It's easier to style the avatar if it isn't moving. Anyways, I'm not a huge fan of the hair. It's not horrible, but it has no shape, so the avatar doesn't catch your attention. Since shape, color, and texture catch people's attention, always try to emphasize those aspects. Moving on, I found a similar hair but with longer pigtails. I also don't think these stars are necessary. They're hardly visible, and they will probably get covered by other items. I can tell the theme relies on stars, so I will find a better replacement for these golden stars later. Anyways, the color distribution is not balanced. There is a lot of blue on the upper half and barely any on the lower half. So I'm replacing the white star keychain with a blue one. The colors don't exactly match, but it's okay. I'm also removing the baby bottle because it's blue and it clutters the face. I know the creator was going for a baby or child outfit, so I'll switch the baby bottle with something else. I found this in the Roblox marketplace. Anyways, I'm gonna add an anime hat for the kawaii child vibe. I'm gonna try to find something similar to this one. It's cute, but it doesn't mix with the avatar. I found this one. Cute. Okay, going back to what I said earlier. Let's find some stars. Trying to find star aura or confetti. I think this is the one, but I saw some others earlier. Let me confirm my choice. Yep, this one is the best choice. There is some green in the stars, so I want to balance that color on the avatar. I'll do it on the backpack since the midsection of the outfit has a lot of pink. Ooh, this one is nice. Let me see if there are any other good ones. I like how this one covers more of the back. Finally, let's add some more yellow. And we are done with this outfit. Before. After. Okay, now on to the third outfit. These next avatars are going to be from Discord. This time I am using Catalog Avatar Creator because the avatar is in R6. First off, I'm not a fan of the face. Just like the other avatars, let's remove unneeded items. You can barely see the veil, so I'm removing that. The tiara kind of blends into the hair. I could replace it with a colored one later on. Wait, this outfit has so much potential, oh my god. This can totally become a webcore styled avatar. For reference, the webcore style looks like this. I don't think I will make the outfit a 100% webcore, but I'll heavily reference the webcore style. As you saw a few moments ago, I equipped fake headless because webcore looks better with headless. The creator was going for a mermaid look, so I'm gonna add an ocean environment. For now, I'm looking for water around her feet. This one is too chaotic. Ooh, I like this one. Adding bubbles because the ocean has lots of bubbles. Whoa, this hair looks cool. Sadly, you can see the fake headless. I really like the pink and blue hair on this avatar. No, so many of these show the fake headless. Yay, this hair looks good. Whenever I make an ocean-related outfit, I always include jellyfish items. They just work so well. Wow, this one is cute, but I'm not sure if I want it. Perfect. I love it. I remember seeing a really cute fish accessory. I remembered the name. She looks ethereal so far. She needs something on her head. It's looking pretty empty. Oh my god, wow. This fits the avatar so well. The tail also looks like a mermaid tail. Also, I'm adding this one again because it matches well with the other head item. It looks a little bit cluttered. This one has a nice detail, but it also makes the avatar a little messy. Together, I'm not too sure though. The outfit looks amazing from the front, but looks messy from the back. I can't choose to keep or remove the sparkles and trident. What do you guys think? Should I remove the sparkles and trident? Comment down below. Before. After. Now let's find our last person. we have Mavis's. First of all, her avatar is already great. I honestly don't think I'm gonna change much. Her fit looks like a car racer, so I'm adding a motorcycle. I used this motorcycle in my favorite avatar. I love how it looks, so I'm glad to use it again. Anyways, take a look at the color distribution. She used the sandwich method from the neck down. However, you need to look at the outfit as a whole in order for the sandwich method to work properly. So, I'm removing the white goggles and adding some pink to the head. I also want to add a helmet to accentuate the car racer vibes. Whoa, this one fits well. I just don't like how there is no black on it. The goggles are really bright, and they're in the spotlight. I could try to cover it up with black goggles. I'm okay, so it looks kinda weird, but it looks fine from a distance LOL. This one looked the best compared to the others too. Also, the black hair blends in with the motorcycle, so let's change the hair color. Personally, I think the avatar would look better with the hair down, but it doesn't matter that much. I think any hairstyle would look fine for this outfit. I'm debating between the pink hair and white hair. I'm also adding fake headless on this outfit. Okay, the white hair looks better to me. But you can see the fake headless, so I'll cover it up with bangs. I want to add more pink to the face area. The original head sparkles, but they blend into the hair. Instead, I'll replace them with pink sparkles. This one is good. Finally, let's add one last detail, car keys. And there we have it. Before. After. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I mostly went for a detailed approach for these avatars. I would say my yassification would be just detailing them. If you would like to join a part 2, subscribe for community posts or join my Discord server. The server link will be in the description below. I had a lot of fun making this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see y'all again next time. Love you always. Bye.